world is changing and we need to adapt. I have a bit of innovation fatigue. The word innovation is a buzzword.
If you're not actually innovating, if you're not thinking more critically, if you're not thinking through complex problems, then yeah, it's a buzzword.
I always put forward the problem.
It's a problem statement. I actually sit them in a room and I'll say, nothing's crazy. There's no crazy ideas here. Thinking of way beyond the boundaries of what's previously been done.
We must think and do better because the challenges that our communities are facing, the issues, the money, the lack thereof, they're all changing at an exponential rate. We don't have an option but to innovate at that same rate.
No place is safe, and every place can use technology to address the speed of change in our world today.
Modeling flood in the traditional way around the globe would take thousands and thousands of years using these old models. Flood Predictor takes the traditional engineering models and it applies AI to those models in order to make predictions. A traditional study can take 90 days, and with Flood Predictor, I just ran a simulation this morning, it took 15 minutes.
We don't have time. We don't have time to see if a traditional idea fails anymore.
So the building sector contributes to 40% of these in greenhouse gas emissions. What we tend to offer is the carbon cost modeling. We want to make sure that first we're planning for targets that are achievable, and that is done by understanding your building's consumption of energy, trying to reduce that at first, and then what are the opportunities? What are things that you can integrate early on to those designs that could serve to reduce those emissions?
The old Flume Bridge used to transfer nearly half of the region's water supply. If we get a big seismic event or a big earthquake, the old concrete box was going to end up in the river. The original project was to actually fix the old bridge up. And then we went, that's not right. We're not going to get resilience and longevity by fixing the bridge up. So we started to think about how can we put a bridge in there to work with nature, not work against it. This was built with a 100-year design life. There will be lots of generations that will have the water supply protected.
Stantec's Vulnerability Assessment Program is a resource where we can understand assets and hazards in a very short amount of time. The purpose is to reduce the risks to our communities, is to reduce vulnerability, and to ensure that when investments are made at your community, at whatever level, that that investment is well thought out. We have to think more broadly about how our plans, our investments, our projects are not just happening in the community, but they are becoming the community.
We cannot afford to keep pumping out carbon emissions into the atmosphere, right? We're gonna need clean energy technologies like nuclear. Conventional nuclear plants, you have very, very large nuclear islands. You have a very large reactor pressure vessel. But with these small modular nuclear reactors, some of the technologies run at atmospheric pressure, so you don't need large plant and large equipment anymore. A 300 megawatt SMR can power 300,000 homes. A gigawatt, you know, you're really up there now. You're at a million homes, right? They're the kind of energy levels we're talking about. You no longer need to have hundreds of acres of land to do this kind of thing. I strongly believe every community in the future will end up having some form of nuclear energy.
When I look back on my life, I have two key goals. I want to give more than I take, and I want to change the world.
For me, it's the people we worked with. It's the solution that we give for the people that will benefit from this for a long time after we're done.
I love the problem of technology with a complex field like engineering and science.
To be able to be part of the industry and the frontier of energy and innovation and technology, it is a pinch-me moment for me.
I'm so inspired that my kids see how meaningful my work is. It makes me want to wake up the next day and do better.
I'm proud that Stantec cares to put people like me in positions to make a difference.